with eventual release for the public at the fall conference. A link to this event will be provided to all contestants. This event will be made public at the fall conference. It is requested, forget that, if you do not want to be videotaped, raise your hand now. Okay. He's kidding, but she's not. I'm sure.
Okay, and that's okay.
Tim Bolger is videotaping this event, and it will be released publicly after at the fall conference, not before. Anybody have any questions? Thank you all for joining us today at South Division Humorous Speech and Evaluation Contest. If you do not know, I am LaShonda Milton, the South Division Director. Woo! Thank you all for coming. And at this time, we're going to have distinguished Toastmaster Pat Martin to come with our inspirational message.
Good morning. I have to say it. I am so excited about being here today. Mano Division Director, our Mano District Director, and fellow Toastmaster, our honored guests, our family and friends.
Good morning, fellow Toastmasters! than it makes when it's vibrating. It'd be nice to turn them on, but of course it is your option. I would like to start off by saying, today is a tailgate party. What do we do at parties? Those who do party, unlike me, what do you do? Do you get excited?
Yeah!
Speaker number four, Charles Brooks. Speaker number five, Elizabeth Stevenson. And speaker number six, Sherry Allen Reeves. I'm gonna do this one more time. Speaker number one, Michael Gugis. Speaker number two, Angela Nguyen. Speaker number three, Sadia Mathis. Speaker number four, Charles Brooks. Speaker number five, Elizabeth Stevenson.
and speaker number six, Sherry Allen Reeves. In order to have a contest, we must have a test speaker. Our test speaker for today is Salma Ahmed. Salma Ahmed. And unfortunately, I didn't get the name of the speech.
The role of an instructional coach.
The role of an instructional coach, Salma Ahmed.
Instructional coach in a school by stepping into the classroom. Many classrooms each day, every school day, in two buildings covering 73 plus teachers. Surprise! That's what I do. I surprise the teachers. I know it looks like a beautiful package there, but believe me, when they see me, they're like, oh gosh, she's here. Unfortunately or fortunately, I think it's more fortunate in the long run. The surprise is that I will enter the classroom, I will find a spot maybe in the back of the room, just like we have here, sit myself down. If there's no place to sit, I stand, and I use my iPad, and I have a walkthrough app here, which I use to evaluate what I'm seeing in the classroom. It's an app that covers four different components: lesson delivery, differentiation, resources in the classroom, and the classroom environment. I look for many different things. What is going on in the classroom? What are the teacher doing and saying? What are the students doing and saying? What is the task? How will the teacher know the students have learned the objective today? Where will the teacher continue the next lesson? These are all the things that I'm gathering information from. I use the app, I use a little notebook as well, in case I don't have enough time to jot down on the checklist. And I go back and I write it all up. Within the hour, they will get an email with this walkthrough app. It's a four-page document that I will complete in detail, and they will get it within the hour of my visit. Once they see that document, I will go ahead and schedule a follow-up meeting. What that entails is they have the document, they've had 24 hours or so to look it over. We will meet face-to-face. I believe in meeting face-to-face. We can clear out any discrepancies. We go ahead and meet, and I will begin with saying, how do you think the lesson went? The teacher will go ahead and share everything about that lesson. Once I hear, my main job here is to do what? Is to listen. I need to hear what the teacher is saying. Once that is done, I will also give my suggestions, my input. We will have that document, I will create a Google Doc. A Google Doc for each teacher and teacher's aide. So that actually raises to about 100 Google Docs. I keep it up to date. I send all this information. With the Google Doc, I write out what the teacher said, and I bullet point it, not in complete sentences or paragraphs, otherwise it would become a book. After that, I write down what I suggested. And then, I create an action plan if necessary. An action plan is, for example, I notice the teacher has a really hard time starting the class on time. It's wasting minutes, it's wasting instruction time. What do? We come up with strategies, we come up with an action plan, a deadline, a timeline. And that way, we can go ahead and monitor the opening activities of the lesson. And same with closing. You know, start on time, end on time, the bell system. And that's basically what we do. And then all these documents are sent to admin, to administration. So the principal will get this document, the vice principal will get this document, I will also copy myself on it, and of course the teacher also herself will get that document as well. So as you see, ladies and gentlemen, this is an ongoing professional development for the teacher, but not only is it professional development, it's personalized, so that they can actually improve their teaching from point to point as the year progresses. This is a sample of the walkthrough app that I was talking about. I know it's kind of hard to see, but it's basically a sample of a completed evaluation. This is a commercial app. It's not customized to MCC Academy where I work, but it's important to customize it to your school culture. For example, we have an issue with dress code. So what I did is I took the dress code policy from our staff handbook and inserted it into the evaluation. So that way we can keep track of what's going on, okay? So these are just some of the ways that we can actually customize the app for our school. During our dialogue, how can I make learning more powerful in the classroom? We go over things like, did you realize that you were going over answers to the worksheet when only half the students were done? Or did you realize you took 4 minutes to transition? Or did you realize that when you were reading the story, it was you that was summarizing it every few sentences? How about giving the students a chance to summarize? They can gauge their understanding. We had our early childhood put in bits of paper on the number two, on a bubble number two as an art project. There was the word number two, T-W-O, written on the bottom. Expose it to them. When I met with this teacher, she didn't even realize that the number two was written on the bottom. So use it as a learning opportunity. The casual walkthrough, that is something where I do not use my app. It is a more relaxed visit, where I actually observe the bulletin boards, the efforts that all these hard-working teachers put into their work, into their classrooms, into their students. It's a chance for a brag note. This is what the teachers think of me as my role in the classroom today, even though we're not surprised and they're not happy to see me. At the end of the day, they do appreciate what I do because it is an ongoing professional development and I do act as a coach. I'm not the evaluator, the principal is. I'm the coach, so I get to do the fun things with the classroom. Summary. So basically, overall, we start off the day with visiting classrooms one by one. I do my planning each week. We do the follow-up. We have an action plan if that's necessary. And then we just go ahead and, again, admin is all involved, so they're able to come into any of my observations, enter into any of my documents, and also edit it. But the cycle continues. We work together as a team, and that's what makes our school successful at MCC Academy. Thank you.
Or the dedicated area. waiting on the 5 minutes to elapse. We're going to get to know our test speaker for today. Please help me to welcome back to the floor, Ms. Salma Ahmed.
To work 15 minutes or less.
How does that feel?
I'm great.
Oh my Lord, that is great. I just started something similar to that April 1st. My commute is less than a minute.
Oh, wow.
I hop out the bed, brush my teeth, and go and sit down and eat my family.
Suggest that you use PowerPoint. I mean, we have this stuff available. A laptop would have allowed you to stand behind it, maintain your eye contact with the audience, yet spy whatever it was and eliminate the need for an assistant. You could have used a remote. That would have freed you up to come out and engage with your audience more. And then when you needed to, you could go back to your presentation. But I thought that everything went very smoothly, although sometimes having the notes over here was a burden, and at times you would put your head down and thus lose projection. So it's by standing erect, maintaining your eye contact longer, you engage everyone in the audience. And you'll notice with this strange configuration, it's not practical to start walking back and forth. All you need to do is simply turn your head and seek to make eye contact with everyone in the room. But I think overall, a great job, but you can become an even greater speaker. Madam Contest.
Contestant number two, Angela Musis. Angela Musis, contestant number two.
Madam Contest Master, fellow Toastmasters, guests, and especially Sama, is there anyone in this room who knew that an instructional coach existed before today?
No, I didn't know.
Just a couple people knew what this even was. When I heard the title of your speech, I became very excited because I'm not an instructional coach, but I'm in organizational development, and people don't understand what career coaching is much either, which is some of what I do in my career. So thank you, first of all, for educating so many people today on the fact that this very important role exists and helps our students because we help improve our teachers. And that's very important. As far as a speech is concerned, there are a few key points that we look for when we evaluate a speech. And I'd like to share some insights with you today of what I observed. Your organization, I thought, was well done. You had very clear points and steps that you summarized throughout the speech. Within the organization, I felt the opening could have been even stronger. You could have really tugged at us by saying something like, how many of you have had a really outstanding teacher? You can thank an instructional coach. Right? So you can open up and grab there, how many of you have had a horrible teacher? They probably didn't have someone like me. And open that up and get us in to help us understand why we care about what an instructional coach does. Your voice and vocal variety and how you use your words is another thing that we look at, and I thought that you could have probably spoken a little bit louder for this particular room, and you do have it in you because you had that big surprise, which really got us. So a little bit more variety, a little bit more pops like that and punches will really keep everyone engaged throughout. As far as notes are concerned, the room I think is a bit awkward, and the visual aids were somewhat hard to see over on that side of the room. Possibly having handouts available doesn't necessarily have to be for everyone, but at least something that could get passed around would be great to have that available. I don't feel like you used your notes too much. You did reference them a couple times, but they were on cards. Feel free to hold those cards in your hand, so you don't have to keep going back to that one spot. As far as the topic and the audience relevance, I thought you made it relevant to the audience with the topic that you chose by saying, I don't work with kids, I don't teach a sport, and really giving them an idea, I still do the same things. You summarize what those things are so well for us. You visit, it's a surprise, you follow up with them, you create an action plan with them, and you share it with others so that you can hold them accountable. Overall, I think some of the things you might want to focus on as far as future speeches are
having visual aids or handouts that are easier for people to see. Really grab us with a strong opening and use a little bit more vocal variety, but keep on speaking about what you know and relating the topic to the audience the way you do and having those clear points for us and summarizing it so well. Madam Contest Manager.
Contestant number three, Sadia Mathis. Sadia Mathis, contestant number three.
Yeah. counselors and welcome guests, and especially Selma. I never heard the title instructional coach. I heard about a lot of coaches, but I thought you did a wonderful job in explaining it because I thought that your opening really defined who you were, what your job was, all those different things that you're responsible for doing to make sure that the teaching in the classroom is effective. I thought that you had a very full body, and in your conclusion, I thought that it was just a bit quick, but we'll get to that. So a lot of the things that you did well was that you moved well. You used the room. You didn't just have to walk all the way over there, but you used your head to turn and look at people. You used gestures, and a lot of them. And you used a little humor. You got us laughing. And you had very, very good eye contact. And you seemed to be very comfortable up here. It didn't seem that there was any nervousness about you. Your voice was clear, and you had a steady speaking speed too. Your enunciation was good, and your pronunciation, I understood every word that you said. You had great storytelling ability too, because it was like listening to someone telling a story about themselves and what they did. Now, how can we improve your speech? Because part of my responsibility is to help you get from this speech to the next speech. So some of the things that I noticed was that your movement should be purposeful. And your pausing, you should use effective pausing, give your audience an opportunity to take in what you're saying. Your gestures, you had gestures that were mainly up here. Gesture should always start down here. If you have a problem with that, you have a long sleeve shirt on, you grab it and you hold on to it. That keeps your hands down. And then your gestures come up, but they have purpose when they move. How else could you improve your speech? Your visual aids. Although you had some assistant over here with visual aids, they were very small. So I would suggest a flip chart or a PowerPoint presentation, or handouts to the audience, because with all that information, you want people to take that information with them. And I thought that that handout would have served a very good purpose. Other than that, I enjoyed your speech. I enjoyed you. You were very comfortable. You taught us something new. And I'm always open to new ideas, new things that people do. So with the last thing that I want to comment on is the conclusion. I thought it was a little quick, and I thought that you could have summarized a little bit of the thing because you had so much information, so a summary would have been great. So other than that, I enjoyed the speech, and thank you for participating, and I look forward to your next presentation. Madam, tell us.
Contestant number 5, Elizabeth Stevenson, contestant number 5. interesting speech project we heard this morning. The role of an instructional coach. This could have been from an advanced manual because of the type of speech that she was giving, a presentation for us. But I believe this was a speech where she was required to use several different types of audiovisual aids. An audiovisual aid speech project is a difficult one because sometimes your aids don't work. This opportunity was full of information. She was on point with content. She talked about something that she loved. She began giving us information about how she went into the schools and what she did step by step. I would have loved to be able to see her presentation. She had a helper and she had her slides, but they were somewhat small and difficult to read. When you have a situation like that, you can compensate for that. How? By saying, I have slides, they're going to be smaller than what you can see from where you are seated. I have handouts for you. I can pass out information, something that you can take away. I loved that this was a topic that was near and dear to her heart. How do I know? Because she exuded some excitement about this topic. Now, it might not have been interesting to everyone in the room, and that's something hard to do with a technical type of presentation. I was reminded of a little saying that I saw on Facebook: don't waste your words on people who deserve your silence. Sometimes the most powerful thing you can say is nothing at all. And what I'd like to recommend is take a pause, take a break. Sometimes the voice was so soft that we might not have heard everything you had to say. And yet I felt that you were hurrying to say everything that you wanted to get done in your 7 minutes and 24 seconds that you had. If I had to say, give you a grade and give you a rating, I would say I'm looking forward to your next project that will incorporate the things that you did well, with some improvements on handling so many types of extra slides, technical, but great job all in all, and I'm looking forward to what you do with that information. Madam Counselor.
Number six, Sherry Allen Reed. Sherry Allen Reed's contestant number six.
Cockman Contest Chair, and all distinguished guests, and especially Salma. Wow, your speech was quite interesting. The role of an instructional coach. So, given the theme, we all pretty much thought it was about football. And then you surprised us with the big surprise. You surprised us to let us know it was about the role in the classroom as an instructional coach. Now that surprised a lot of us because of the fact that generally we don't know what goes on in the classroom. We don't know that there's someone in the back of the room actually evaluating the teachers and how that happens. So it was quite interesting and very relatable, particularly for those who were parents here in the room. But you started off a little bit, I have some suggestions for you, because you started off a little bit nervous. And you were kind of figuring out what you were going to say and how you were going to say it. And it was all going on in your head. And we can kind of, we noticed that. And using someone to hold your props was interesting. But I think you relied on her because she didn't go when you were ready. So that was kind of a challenge for you in some respects. But your speech was very good. And we learned a lot about what happens in the classroom. The other thing that I thought that you might want to work on is your hand gestures. You use your hands a lot, and I found myself looking at them to see what was going to happen. And a lot of times we should just use our hands with purpose, maybe keep them down. There was a suggestion that one of my mentors told me to always wear a jacket that I can just hold here so that I don't use my hands so much. So I make that suggestion to you. And also, there wasn't a lot of movement about your space. We have a whole room here, and you could have used that space a little bit more effectively. So that would be my suggestion. Excellent speech, in summation, excellent speech. Use your hands more effectively. Breathe. Take your time. And relax. And know that what you're giving is valuable information, and people can really use it. And with that, I thank you.
And I will still support them, even though they insist on keeping Jay Cutler. I truly am a Bears fan through and through, and I do have my other sports teams. My boyfriend has informed me we will be up at 8:30 in the morning to watch the game being played in London tomorrow morning. So we will be watching football all day tomorrow, because that's what we do. Well, I've been in Toastmasters 9 years, and my favorite quote is by a woman named Barbara Sher, who's a motivational speaker and writer, and she said, "Everyone has unique gifts and talents. What you love is what you're gifted at. To be truly happy, to live a completely fulfilled life, you have to do what you love." And I live by that, and I had a career change because of it, and truly believe if you do what you love, you are actually giving the world a gift.
Y'all look like I'm 9 years old. What is your favorite?
from Maya Angelou, who says people will forget people will forget what you said, and people will forget what you've done, but people will always remember how you made them feel. And I'm paraphrasing that, but people will always remember it. That's very important.
Yes, it is. Well, on behalf of our subdivision director, LaShonda Milton, DTM, we want to thank you. Here's a ribbon of participation. Thank you.
receive another email from me, Ms. Doty. I didn't think.
Yes.
So come on down to the fall conference. There's plenty of room. There's hot right here in Chicago. So we're gonna party like it's 1999.
Clubs clubs that had trained, 21 clubs, 13 of those 21 clubs had 7 officers trained. Woo! And the remaining clubs had a minimum of 4 officers trained. Now we have the 4 clubs who don't meet in the summertime, and we're working on trying to get them to at least have 4 officers trained for the next go round. Okay. However, I want to take this time and recognize each one of those clubs. I sent out emails to the clubs that had 7 officers trained because I thank them for their efforts. However, as I was looking or thinking about it, what do I do for my clubs that only had 4 officers trained? It's just not fair not to acknowledge them. So I decided to recognize each club individually, and if there's any representatives here, I want you to come and take your certificate. This is a certificate of achievement that acknowledges Bellwood Toastmasters successfully obtained the South Division Leadership Training Award for having a minimum of 4 officers trained during round 1. The South Division's motto this year is reaching new heights. And our division's district director's motto is soar on wings like eagles so we can reach new heights. Yeah. Bellwood Toastmasters is my first club. Going to school, working, doing some other stuff. Oh, I started my own business. If anybody needs to know what that is, come see me. So a lot of things going on. I didn't want to make the commitment because anybody know me know I go over and beyond, but I need to have time to go over and beyond, right? So I said, well, I'll tell you what. If you can find me two assistants, unfortunately, neither one of them are here. One is Jerome Rowley. His father passed away, so there. And then my other one, Lawrence Fields, on vacation. You find me two people, I'm good. She emailed me back. I got two people for you. Jerome Rowley. It was Jerome Rowley and Lily Simmons. So I reached out to both of them. Jerome called me immediately, like, oh, Sean, I hear you want to do this stuff. I'm good. I'm great. Lily said, I'm going to run for division director downtown. Fine, no problem. So I tried it again. I said, I can't do it. I only have one. She said, got somebody else. Lawrence Fields. They are the perfect assistants for me because I didn't want to get my hands. I always get my hands in. I always get my hands in. So I wanted to be a person to just delegate and hold them accountable and evaluate. So that's what they've done for me. But not only that, my team. Woo-hoo! You know, you never know who people are picked in your path. So because of the former South Division governor, Cassandra Lee, and their team, they actually reached out to find people successors. Not knowing who the lead was gonna be, but this was my team. I was missing one person. And when that one person, Mutti, I found that I was running, she said, I'll be the sixth area director. And I wanna thank them for that, because I haven't done anything. They knew it all. And the other one says, keep up the good work.
All right.
And I wanted to give each one of them their pens because they have done this first quarter magnificently. I could not have done it, but they have done it. And I'm sure you all get the emails. I know from Area 55. I know Area 55 gets the emails because I get them too. Get on your thing, and they're only doing what's required of them. And if you all can just acknowledge that, understand that, we're trying to achieve excellence, and it has to start somewhere. And I just want to acknowledge them publicly and say thank you for your efforts, and I love you all. So, I got two things. So, each of the club were
supposed to come with their DCP program, the Stingers Club program, and determine whether or not they want to be President's Distinguished or not. So I have two clubs here who wanted to be President's Distinguished, and for that, district director gave them a high performance leadership manual because their club is aimed at President's Distinguished, and this is from Area 54, BLT and Pathfinders. So I have that. Members, and we talk about the clubs, and we talk about the areas and the vision, that's me. And then let's talk about the district. So, who has those people where when you call them and ask them to do an email to do something, they do it right away? Or who has those people who you call them, email, and ask them to do something, and they never do it? Or they take forever. Or they take forever, you know, it's forever. It's, like, really? Come on now, really? Okay, first round training. I sent out emails. The area director sent out emails with discrepancy. I know they went to the club to find out who gets the job done. Make sure you get credit. Then there was an email sent to me, to the club. Email sent to our program quality director about discrepancies. And she handled it like ASAP. And I want to take that time to acknowledge her, because if it wasn't her getting it in, we couldn't say that we got 80.7%. So I want to take the time, certificate of appreciation, thank you to our program quality director, Barbara Beckley, the state coach. Thank you.